Hello everybody, welcome to a new episode of DYRC Eachine E016 range test. We're first going to start and test the range without any modifications. Then we go do a small modification to the quadcopter and the joystick and test the range again. Like I did with so many others of my Eachine 816 micro drone brothers. So let's get ahead. I'm gonna put it on high rates and let's see how far it flies. Landed way past that passenger. It's about 60 meters away. Let's go on, find it. Okay, let's count the steps. Starting with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55. I can hear it. We are close. We are very close. It's right there in those bushes. I was at 55, so 56, 57, 58, 59, 60. Upside down, it doesn't make any noise, but I was super lucky. It was upside down, of up, the right way up, so the motor starts spinning and makes a little bit of noise. That's nice, at 67 meters. So it makes it 60, little bit of wind, plus minus range, loose signal, and then it continues flying a little bit because the props don't stop. This doesn't drop out of the air, it's got a fail-safe security. That makes us go slowly back to the ground. So, 60 meters, stock range. Let's go back to the bench and make some modifications. And the first step of improving the range of the Eachine 16 is opening up the radio, removing the batteries, always. Then get that little screwdriver that came with the package. And this is the antenna that we are looking for. Pretty small. The plastic of the radio blocks some part of the signal, so the range is a lot shorter. I'm gonna make a little opening for the antenna to poke outside the radio and giving us extra range with just a small simple modification for free. And now I put the circuit board back in its case. And then first letting the antenna poke outside. And I'm gonna do the same for the drone. But it's first getting the safety guards off is gonna be a little bit tricky. It's gonna be attached on 3 points on all sides of the 12 clips that we have to get undone. When all the clips are loose, the frame should come undone. Now we have a bunch of wires. Like spaghetti. Here we got the antenna wire. We're gonna have to stick outside the canopy. This is the front of the drone. And check what is the front of this drone. So that means it's gonna be Right where I hold my thumb. Yes, sir. Here she comes. That's the finished product. And let's go back to the range test facility and check the range.
We are back at the range facility with the E16. Let's see how much more range we have with the new modification. All right. A little bit windy. Let's see how it feels. Oh, she's far away. And I lost it in the trees. Let's see where the drone has landed, and let's see if we can find it and recover it. Fingers crossed. Meters. 20 meters. 40 meters. Meters. That was the range that we got when it was completely stopped. 70. Oh, I can hear it. Oh, there it is. 80, 90, 100 plus minus. Man, that's awesome. Let's fly back. Because with the light, it makes it super visible. It was the light that made it like, hey, what's coming up with the grass? Can it fight the wind? Can we fight the wind? Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Come on, baby. There she is. Super stable. Never had such a stable drone like this. As a micro drone, of course. I thought that the E10 and the E11 was the best ever. Yeah, the wind comes and picks it up and blows away, but fantastic at 100 meters. I really like it. I also really like this drone. I hope you like it. You find all the links down below in the description. And hope to see you next time. Goodbye, and thank you all for watching so far. And next time we're gonna test how much thrust we have and how much weight it can carry, making it ready for FPV. Goodbye.